All right, I've been told that we have Pratik Agarwal joining us. He's business head and CIO of ASK Investment Managers. Pratik, thank you very much. Great to have you with us here. Prashant this side. I have to ask you a quick one on the budget, Pratik. In your mind, is this do you have high expectations, or are you okay one way or the other? You think the market may react in the short term, but largely it's going to be quite okay post that.
So, frankly, on the taxation front, I expect this to be a no-change budget. And, if I can let my imagination fly and hope for the best, maybe some cuts in the surcharges that have been imposed. See, please remember last year, when the COVID had hit, they had increased taxes on fuel. And while that helped last year, this year when normalcy is getting restored, it is going to give the government sizably higher revenues. So it will already have more revenues from the people. So expectation is that rest of the taxes will be kept constant, and maybe some of the surcharges, otherwise you will keep having one surcharge over the other. Some surcharges getting reduced. So that said, really believe the if this is the outcome, then I think there will be a relief rally after the budget.
Pratik, morning. What about the markets per se? We've already seen about a 4% correction from the top. Do you think markets are ripe for a deeper correction, say a fall, in totality of close to about 10 odd percent, all things considered?
Let me try and answer it in a different form. What is the return one expects to have if one invests in the market at the current levels? If we go forward, yes, this result season is good, etc. We will end this year at probably over 500 EPS on the Nifty, next year closer to 700, the year after it 800. Put a discount rate to 800, you arrive at a 16,000 kind of a number for the index. That gives you 12-13% from where we are. If that return is a good return for you and the general investing public, for example, then these levels will hold. My sense is these are. These are because liquidity is high. You look at the results, every bank is reporting very strong CASA increases. Now, saving banks are giving sub 4% returns. If the market, logically speaking, is offering you 10-12% kind of returns, chances are that people will take it versus the alternative, and hence expect levels to sustain.
Pratik, any particular themes now or post the budget that you would have on the top of your mind?
So let me see, this time around when the budget is being tabled, there is very little pressure of the FISC. The globe, it's every country is treating 1 year to be less from the life of the nation, from the life of a person, whatever way you look at it, because of COVID. So every country is giving itself 1 year, one extra year to come back to the fiscal consolidation path. If IMF projects 11.5% growth for India, and like I said, some extra taxes being imposed, our position should be quite okay. Now, with less of the oversight, let me say, on FISC, the ability of the government to do quite a few things becomes very high. What otherwise it would have let go because of the consideration of the FISC, it can probably attempt. So let us see, how the imaginations are put to work in this budget. That said, I really believe, we will see some amount of public-private partnerships in many of the problems which are there. Lower interest rates definitely help. InvITs is a great instrument. Frankly, they have done that 2 or 3 years back, and now we will see more and more of it getting used. So, with lower interest rates, doing an InvIT offering 7-8% to the population, I would believe would see reasonable amount of success. A lot of the disinvestments may happen that way. Let us see For example, bad bank. Do we need a bank for a bad bank? It could be a fund wherein the population participates while the government may catalyze and ensure governance. Same way for having liquidity backstop for the NBFCs. No, RBI need not do it. A fund could do it as well. So let us see. There can be a lot of ideas, but I am of the camp that doesn't really want the government to do too much on its own. I'm in the camp which wants the government to put the framework, catalyze it, and let the people do the rest of the job for themselves.
Prateek, we'll have to leave it at that. Thanks so much for joining in. On that note, it's time for a short break. We'll come back with more.